Okay, here comes the first question. A small hole of area of cross section 2 mm square is present near bottom of a fully filled open tank of height 2 m. Taking g equal to 10 m per second square, the rate of flow of water through the open hole would be nearly. Okay, as per this problem, we need to consider an open tank which is fully filled. That means the height up to which water is filled, that is equal to height of the tank itself, since it is fully filled. Then again, given that there is a hole at the bottom of the tank through which water flows out, so after a certain time that tank becomes empty. But what they have asked, you need to calculate the rate of flow of water through this open hole. So what do you mean by rate of flow of water? It is nothing but the amount of water flowing out per second, that is known as rate of flow of water, or we can say the volume of water flowing out per second. Let's consider the rate of flow of water as Q. This can be written as volume of water flowing out per second, or we can write this as volume. Volume can be written as area into height, no? So area into height is volume, that much volume flowing out per second. Or again, we can write this as area into height by time. So what do you mean by height by time or distance by time? Distance by time is nothing but speed. Therefore, we got an expression for rate of flow of water Q equal to area into speed. Which is the speed? The speed with which the water flows out through this hole, that is nothing but velocity of efflux. For a open tank, what is the expression for velocity of efflux? V equal to root of 2gh. So first you need to calculate that value of V and area. Area is given here, that is 2 millimeter square, but you need to convert that into meter square. So 2 millimeter square means 2 into 10 power minus 6 meter square. So those values of V and A you need to substitute in this expression so that you can calculate rate of flow of water through this hole. So let's calculate that. As I said, first we need to calculate velocity of efflux, that is nothing but root of 2gh. So 2 into g, as per this problem, it is given in that problem, you can take g as 10 meter per second square, acceleration due to gravity. And h, what is h value? That is equal to height of the tank itself, because it is fully filled. Okay, therefore if you simplify or if you calculate the value, you will get 6.32 meter per second, that is velocity of efflux. So area is given, so directly you can substitute that. So q equal to av, so substitute the value of a. As I said, if you convert that into meter square, that will be 2 into 10 power minus 6 meter square into value of V you need to substitute, and just simplify this, you will get 12.6 into 10 power minus 6 meter cube per second. Okay, so you can consider option B as correct answer. Okay, let's move on to second question. There is a hole of area of cross section A at the bottom of a cylindrical vessel. Water is filled up to height h and water flows out in t second. If water is filled up to height 4h, it will flow out in time equal to. And the options are t, 4 times t, 2 times t, and t by 4. Okay, as per this question, there is a tank, and in that tank initially water is filled up to height h. During that time, or when height of water is h, then if you want to empty that tank, then time required is t second. Okay, that is the first case. When height up to which water is filled is h, then time required is t second. Now instead of height h, if you fill water up to height 4h, then what is the time required to empty that tank? That is a question. So in first case, time required is t. So if in second case, you need to calculate the time required, or you need to compare the time required in second case with that of first case. How to solve this? You have this expression, no? The time required to empty the tank, or time required to empty the vessel. In this particular case, it is vessel. Okay. So, what is the time required? That is given by A by A naught into root of 2H by G. So, what is this A and A naught? A is area of cross section of that vessel, and A naught is area of cross section of that hole. And H is height up to which water is filled. That is the value of H. Okay. And G is acceleration due to gravity. So, in this case, since you need to compare the time required, here you need to take ratio of time required in both cases. So, when you take ratio of time required, these terms A, A naught, G, these are all get cancelled. Why? Because in both case, we are using same tank, no? Only the water height of water level is changing, but that vessel, that is same in both case. Therefore, when you take the ratio of time required to empty the tank in both cases, you can neglect this A, A naught, G and all. That means this T, time required, depends only on root H. That is what I have written here. So, T2 by T1. T2 is time required in second case. T1 is time required to empty the tank in first case. That is equal to root of H2 divided by H1. H2 is height of water in second case, and H1 is height of water in first case. So, you know, height of water in second case is 4H and in first case it is H. So, just substitute those values. So, root of that one. What do you get? HH get cancelled. Root of 4 is 2. Therefore, you got T2 by T1 equal to 2. That implies T2 equal to 2 times T1. Or in this particular case, T1 is given as T. Therefore, T2 equal to 2 times T. What do you mean by this? The time required to empty the vessel in second case is twice that of time required to empty the vessel in first case. T2 equal to 2 times T. Okay. Therefore, which is the option? Option C is correct. Okay. Okay. Let's move on to question number 3. A tank is filled up to a height H with a liquid and is placed on a platform of height H from the ground. To get maximum range XM, a small hole is punched at the distance Y from free surface of the liquid. Then, the options are XM equal to 2H, XM equal to 1.5H, and Y equal to H, and Y equal to 0.75H. Okay. Now, as per this problem, you need to consider a tank which is placed over a platform. This is a platform. You can see this. Okay. So, over this platform, this tank is placed and the tank is filled with some water. Then, what is the height of platform? The height of platform from here to here, the height is given as H. And again, in this tank, water is filled. Again, the height up to which water is filled, it is also equal to H itself. Okay. So, if you consider total height from here to here, that total height equal to how much? So, H plus H. So, total height will be, you will get 4H. Sorry, 2H. Okay. Here to here, total height is 2H. And given that there is a hole at a depth Y from the free liquid surface. Therefore, a depth from here to here, that is equal to Y. So, what do you need to calculate? You need to calculate the maximum range up to which that water can reach. So, you need to calculate maximum range in this particular case. To calculate maximum range, first get an expression for range. You know, range, X equal to speed into time. Correct, no? X equal to V into T, speed into time. Speed means the speed with which that fluid comes out. It is nothing but velocity of efflux into time. What is time? time taken by this liquid to reach this level. Okay, so speed into time, that gives range. So first try to calculate that general value of that range. Okay, here is the solution. So you need to calculate range. As I said, to calculate range you need speed and time. So first calculate speed. Directly you can calculate using equation of velocity of F flux. Correct, no? So V equal to root of 2gy. Y, the depth from or the distance from free liquid surface to orifice, that is y. So you get root of 2gy, that is speed or velocity of F flux. Then you need to calculate time. Time taken, t equal to root of 2 into 2h minus y by g. Generally we have that expression root of 2 into capital H minus small h divided by g. But in this particular case, instead of capital H, what you need to consider? The distance from here to here, that is equal to h plus h, that becomes 2h, that is what I have written here. Okay, 2h minus y, distance from here to here, divided by g. So just substitute these two values or expressions in this. So velocity into time. So if you just simplify these equations, then finally you will get x range, x equal to root of 4y into 2h minus y. This is not our final answer. We need to calculate maximum range. So this is general expression for range we got. So if you want to get maximum range, always remember the differentiation of maximum value is equal to 0. Very important concept. Okay, this type of concept to be used in electrostatics or gravitation also. For example, problems related to maximum force between two charges or maximum force between two masses. In gravitation, you need to consider masses. So, if in those types of problems, in the case of maximum force, you need to consider this concept. What is that? The differentiation of maximum value equal to 0. So differentiation of x you need to consider. So this is x. Just differentiate this x with respect to y. So d by dy of x, substitute that x, equal to 0. Now this is like root x, no? If we consider this term inside the square root as x, that becomes root x. So differentiation of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Correct, no? So just differentiate that. So 1 by 2 root x into d by dy of the x. This is known as chain rule. Okay, once again you need to differentiate the term inside this square root. Okay, so d by dy of this 4y into 2h minus y, and this value equal to 0. Now again you can write it as it is, these terms, okay, keep it as it is, and just differentiate the terms inside this bracket. So 4y into 2h, what do you get? 4 into 2, 8 hy. So differentiate that 8hy with respect to y. 8hy with respect to y means you will get 8h minus 4y into y, that becomes 4y square. So differentiate 4y square with respect to y. 4 into differentiation of y square. Differentiation of y square is 2y. Therefore 4 into 2y, what do you get? 8y. Okay, that is equal to 0. Now if you take this complete term to right hand side, that becomes 0, no? Then what do you get finally? 8h minus 8y. 8h minus 8y, that is equal to 0. That means 8h equal to 8y, or we get h equal to y. That is, in maximum value or maximum range, what you need to do to get maximum range? What you need to do? Instead of y, you need to substitute h, or instead of h, you need to substitute y. So in this expression, just substitute y equal to h. Here it is given. X max equal root of 4 into y, actually, okay, I will substitute that as h into 2h minus, actually here it is y, I have substituted it as h. So just simplify this, root of 4h square you will get, that is equal to 2h. That means the maximum range is equal to 2h, and here what you got, h equal to y. So which is the answer now? If you look at the options, you have both xm equal to 2h and y equal to h. Therefore, option A and option C both are correct. Question number 4. There is a hole in the bottom of the tank filled with water. If total pressure at bottom is 3 atmospheric pressure, then the velocity of water flowing from the hole is. Okay, here you need to consider a tank filled with some water and there is a hole at the bottom through which water flows out with certain velocity. So that velocity you need to calculate, and given data is the pressure at the bottom. If you consider here, if you consider a point here at the bottom, then at that particular point pressure is given, that is 3 atmospheric pressure. You know, the pressure at this particular point is due to the liquid column above this. Okay, due to this liquid column, you get some pressure at this particular point. That is known as pressure due to liquid column. Okay, now for that you have an expression, pressure due to liquid column, P equal to H into rho into G. What do you mean by H? Height of this liquid column. And rho is density of that liquid and g acceleration due to gravity. Actually in this problem you need to calculate velocity of the flux. So velocity of a flux, you know, for an open tank expression is root of 2gh. But h value is not given, no? Nowhere it is given. Okay, h value is not given, only pressure is given. Pressure at the bottom is given. Now you have this expression for pressure, P equal to h into rho into g. Look at this, you can just rearrange for h from this expression, no? So what do you get if you rearrange for h? Just try to rearrange for h. So h equal to, what do you get? P divided by P divided by rho into g. Correct, no? So h equal to p divided by rho g. Now just substitute this value of h or this expression of h in this. So what do you get? 2 into g into p by rho g. So this g and g get cancelled now. So what is the remaining terms? Root of 2p divided by rho. Now you can calculate because you know the value of p. What is that? 3 into 10 power 5. So 2 into P, 2 into 3 into 10 power 5 divided by rho, that you must know, the density of water, how much? 1000 kg per meter cube or 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. So just simplify this, you will get root of 600 meter per second. So which is the option? Option B is correct. Question number 5. A large open tank has two holes in the wall. One is a square hole of side L at a depth y from the top and other one is a circular hole of radius r at a depth 4y from the top. When the tank is completely filled with water, the quantities of water flowing out per second from both the holes are the same. Then r is equal to. According to this question, you need to consider a large open tank, okay, of certain height, and in that open tank you need to consider two holes. One hole is a square hole of side L which is at a depth y from the top of that tank, and another one is a circular hole of radius r, and that hole is situated at a depth 4y from the top. Okay, now what is question? You need to calculate the radius of this circular hole. That is what given here. Then r is equal to, r means radius of this circular hole you need to find out. Okay. And one more thing is given here. When the tank is completely filled with water, the quantities of water flowing out per second from both the holes are the same. Quantities of water, that means flowing out per second, that means rate of flow of water. Okay, so rate of flow of water through this square hole and through this circular hole will be the same when this tank is completely filled. Okay, so using that you can get an expression for this radius. Okay, here is the solution. So as per the question, Q1 is equal to Q2. No, so what is Q1? Rate of flow of water through square hole. Q2, rate of flow of water through that circular hole. So Q1 equal to Q2. You know the expression for Q. Q equal to area into velocity. So first calculate Q1. That is in the case of square hole, just calculate Q1. So Q1 equal to area into velocity. Area of that square, A1, area of square, side is L. Therefore, area will be, area of square will be side square. That is L square into velocity. Since that hole is situated at a depth y, we can write velocity of a flux through that is 2gy. So that gives the expression for Q1. Similarly, you can calculate Q2, no? Again, area into velocity. It is a circular hole. Then circular hole of radius r. Then how to write area? Pi r square. That gives the area. And velocity, root of 2gh. So whatever the h value, that is situated at a depth 4y. Therefore, root of 2 into g into 4y. So you got Q1 and Q2. Now, just equate that two expressions. So Q1 equal to Q2. Substitute Q1 value and substitute Q2 value and just simplify this and rearrange for R. And finally, we will get R equal to L divided by root of 2 pi. Okay. Therefore, option B is the answer.